commonly referred to as a precursor to metal slug because of its use of robotic vehicles, which are very similar to the slugs. Top Hunter Roddy and Catty is a side-scrolling platform game developed by SNK for the Neo Geo in 1994. To say I would have lost my shit had I played it at the time is an understatement. Its 100 megashot cartridge was over twice the size of the largest NES cart and three times the size of the largest Mega Drive. Standing at a whopping 110 megabytes in total, Top Hunter's colourful graphics and detailed sprites stood head and shoulders above the competition. Maybe I'm wrong, but it didn't and doesn't seem that unusual that I didn't get that much exposure to the Neo Geo as a child. The Neo Geo's outrageous price tag meant that it was out of reach of everyone I knew. In fact, I didn't actually see a Neo Geo in real life until many, many years later. And even then, in an era when 110 megabyte games were considered quite small, it still stood alone. In the game itself, you control the galaxy's top bounty hunters, Roddy and Catty, across four stages before being taken to a final stage to face those four stages' bosses again, and finally the game's main antagonist, Captain Clapton. The four stages or planets are forest, ice, wind and fire, and cleverly, depending on what stage is picked first, the layout of each stage changes. For example, if you were to pick the ice planet before the forest planet, then the forest planet's layout would be different. As you navigate the beautiful two layers of background, which gives the game a 3D effect, collecting items and killing enemies, you can't help enjoy yourself. You can jump on enemies a la Super Mario Brothers, or hit and while holding A, grab, pick up and finally throw them. You can even execute special moves by moving the joystick in certain directions and pressing the attack button. It's not too unsimilar to Street Fighter. The game even has hidden bonus stages, where you can obtain valuable items like power-ups that double your hitting damage or allow you to throw bigger fireballs. Needless to say, finding and travelling around in the robots is extremely useful also, and highly recommended. Fast and frantic with outstanding graphics, Top Hunter's main if not only fault is its difficulty settings. Even at its hardest, it's still way too easy, allowing you to breeze through the game rather quickly, giving it poor replay value and possibly a headache if you purchase it at its high original price. It's still really fun though. So with outstanding graphics, orchestral music and the ability to move from foreground to background, Top Hunter is a great game and 15-year-old me would have loved it.